Here we are at it's 2014 September, and we're at Black Rock Park on the Lower Colorado River Authority Park, and that's Lake Buchanan out there in the background. It's pretty much empty. It's like 30% of level now. Normally there's water right here on the other side of that parking lot, but it's all just grasslands now. So it's real low. And ooh, that's a glary sun. But anyhow, I'll show you some of the park. You can see the RV part of the park over here in the distance. Let me walk over here a little bit more. And here's, this is the main entrance to the park. And if you look out here, you'll see there's an RV over here on the right, and pretty much empty. And it comes over this way. Boy, there's all kinds of deer and exotic animals right behind me. And it says right here it was established in 1939. And that's us way over there in the background. There we are, it's September 2014. Early September, it's like the 5th or something like that, and this is our new little RV, and we're here in Black Rock Park in what's the name of the town? Kingsland, near Kingsland, Texas. It's a pretty place, but boy, was it hot. But it's now like 10 o'clock in the morning, something like that, 9 o'clock. And it's just cool, dry air. And let's see if we can swing around here. This is the rest of the park. And if you look way down through here, that's Lake Buchanan out there, way out there. And unfortunately, it's like down about at least 30 feet down, and you see the park is pretty much empty. This is Black Rock Park, like I said, in the highways out here. And anyhow, it's really nice. It's very pleasant here, nice people, a campground host, and that is real nice. Anyhow, we're gonna go for a walk, and maybe we'll show you some of the water and stuff. And this is all our campsite. It's nice. $25 a night and all you can eat, if you bring enough. Later. Just another view of our campground here, campsite. We have a giant oak tree right behind us, a nice picnic table. We have a fire ring and a barbecue grill that's here for our use. And of course you can't use a fire ring. Burn ban is in effect because you see the ground? It's brown. And way out there past the maintenance building, you can see the lake. Way out there, and it's way down. I'm going to show you the boat launch and that here in a minute. And like from the end of the boat launch, which is normally like 6-8 feet at least deep in the water, it's now like 40 feet above the water. It's amazing. I think I looked on the internet last night, and I think the lake is only at like 30% capacity. So it's not good. Later. Okay, we're walking from our campsite. We're heading down towards the lake here. And you probably can't see too much, but you can see the lake out there. Well, the lake is supposed to be way up here by this fence. And it's not, it's way out there. From the actual campground here, you have to walk about a quarter mile out across where Suzanne's going, about a quarter mile out to the beach. You know, and normally you put your feet in the water right here. So that's low. And I'm gonna take a picture of the boat launch over here. You aren't gonna believe this. Okay, now you see out here these rocks, it looks like a dam. It's not a dam. That was the boat launch, all right? And right here where it drops off hard to the right, Now that's where you would, your boat would be in like 6-8 feet of water right there. But no, it's a long ways from that. You can see way out there, there's a truck. And here's a truck driving along here. And he would be under probably 15-20 feet of water right there. But then it goes down, way down over here. Somewhere out there, it should be almost in my picture, should be a pickup truck. Pretty shaky. But there he goes.
Water line.
Yeah. And anyhow, he's down at the water line, so that truck right there would be under at least like 40 feet of water.
Show this direction where the water line would be by the cabins.
Alright. Now this way, these are cabins that were on the waterfront. And I will show you, if we walk that far, well, I'll show you right by, there's an oak tree right there. And there's right on the other side of that was a break wall for the water, so the waves wouldn't wash the cabins away. Boy, it's a long ways down to the water. But anyhow, and so the economy around here is pretty much ruined because there's no place to launch your boat. You know, see how many boats are out there on the water in this pretty day? None. So if you launch your boat, you better have an amphibian. And here's Suzanne over here hiding in the bushes. And this is all part of the campground here. I should pan back around this. Those are all little nice little cabins. They're all air conditioned and everything. Nice, but there's no business because there's no water. And then over here on the other side of this fence, that's Llano County Park. And that's actually where the boat launch is. But nobody's there either. And of course, we're here and the place is empty, except for us and a couple other people, because in fact, we may be the only ones here now today, I'm thinking. There wasn't any big need to make a reservation, but we did. And we're here. So anyhow, it's so peaceful and cool breeze, dry air. It's nice. It is really nice. Anyhow, okay, park entrance is up this way. And you come down this way, and then there's a couple speed bumps. There's one up there, and there's another speed bump right here. And see, if you're not careful, what happens here is your hitch foot will hit this one. It's much higher, and if it does, it will bust it right off, and it can even knock your trailer off of your hitch, and so your tongue of your trailer would gouge into the stone right into the street right here, and you will drag it with your truck if you have safety chains, and it will keep dragging and dragging and dragging until you get to right here, and somewhere in here you said, we have a serious problem. So we had to jack it back up, put it back on a trailer, on the truck, and move it on in. And then it dawned on me that while I was sleeping, I was thinking about it, and our trailer's got electric brakes, but the electric brakes were hooked onto the safety chains, so it couldn't throw the brakes on the trailer. So that's been remedied now. And then I got to thinking about it also. I said, it's got safety chains. Well, the safety chains was something that the guy added that we bought the trailer from, because when an RV comes off, if should it happen to come off your truck for any reason, like this one did, you want to get as far away from that trailer as you can. So the safety chains are going bye-bye, and the brakes are going to be applied as you're supposed to have them, with a runaway cable that pulls a plunger out of the brake mechanism, which throws the brakes on full. And it stops you, or it stops the trailer. And then you can get out of your truck and look back and say, what happened? But anyhow, no harm, no foul. It never hit the truck, but we did some scraping on the street here. In fact, the campground host comes, he says, did you have a problem with your trailer? And I said, yeah, we did. And he says, man, how did that happen? And I said, well, the foot was too low. And it's funny, because I changed the hitch on the truck before we left Corpus Christi. This was our maiden voyage. And before I left, I changed the hitch so the actual tongue of the trailer was like 4 inches or more higher than it was originally, because it looked like the trailer was terminally going downhill. So we fixed that to it was riding level and tows so much nicer. But anyhow, live and learn, and we learned something there. And that's up ahead, there's that's the main entrance up that way to Black Rock Park, King's Land, Texas. And that's a keeper. Pachow. That's a good buck right there. He'd look good on the wall. Pretty boy.